Shabbat Shalom. I invite everyone to take their seats, take a deep breath on this later entrance of Shabbat, a little more time to get ready. I welcome all those who are joining us on the live stream from your Makom Tefillah. And turn now to Yedid Nefesh on page 10 in Lev Shalem.
Yedid Nefesh HaBarachama Mishoch Avdach El Retzonach Yerutz Avdach Kemo Hayal
Yishtach Ve'amol Adarach Yier Ablo Yedid Utach Min Ofet Zuf Ve'chotach Alleluia to page 11, the Chunar Anana, let us go out and sing to God. That's an invitation for everyone to participate. Bring your voice, bring your heart, bring your soul. The more shy, the more restrained we are, Shabbat is a time for open and expansiveness and freedom, not just to do with a lot of harmony and voice and soul from each and every one. Please make yourself known in that way in the Kahal, page 11. The corner Arbaim Shana.
Thank you.
15, Adonai Malach.
Vatagelena benot Yehuda Leman mishpatecha Adonai, vehodu zecher kodsho.
Age 17, Mizmor, Shir Adonai, Shir Chadash, Kinevrot Asao Shilom.
Zacher Chazdo Lamanetu Lebet Yisrael.
Har Yod Adonai, Kol Haaretz, Vitzchu, Ranenu Vezamim. Yiram Hayam Umlo, Tevel Yosh Reifa,
Top of 20.
Oh, And Shabbat Shalom to everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
On Tuesday, I received the news that Aaron Akabes was in his last hours or days, and he and his wife Shelley were married at BJ, and four generations of their family have been a part of this place for all those years. Shelley died in the late fall after a long illness, and Aaron, at the age of 97, and having been married to Shelley for 70 years, didn't have the will to live without her. I went over to his home, which is just here on 86th Street, and had the privilege of singing to him. I sang B'Shem Hashem, the part which is part of the Sephardic bedtime Shema, which asks that the angels accompany you. And then I sang the Shema with him, and he sang along with me. And afterwards, he turned to me and he said, "That's my favorite. This is the way it's supposed to be." His three children and daughters-in-law and grandchildren had been sitting by his side in those last days, making sure that he was not alone. His room was filled with an enormous amount of love. And in the middle of the night, after that Tuesday, he said goodbye to this world. A moment, a very different kind of moment, happens in this week's parasha, not with the completion of a life, but with the completion of the Mishkan. And the text says, "Vayakom et ha-chatzer saviv le-mishkan, v'la-mizbeach v'yitin et masach sha'ar ha-chatzer, v'yichal Moshe et ha-mlacha, v'yichat ha-anan et ha-ohel mo'ed, u'chvod Adonai malei et ha-mishkan." And he set up the enclosure around the tabernacle and the altar and put up the screen for the gate of the enclosure. When Moshe had finished the work, the cloud covered the tent of meeting and the presence of God filled the tabernacle. The entire sanctuary was filled with God's presence, so much so that Moshe, and next week's parasha, actually doesn't think he can enter. He has to be called in. And it's this incredible moment of completion, of fullness, almost like, I think, that room I sat in on Tuesday night, which was just filled with love and beauty and a sense of completion also. There's a beautiful Hasidic teaching that speaks of this moment that says the entire sanctuary was filled with Israel's love and longing for God because the sanctuary and all its utensils had come from the people's donations and their strong desire to express their love of God. As a result, the Shekhinah rested upon them. All that effort, all the utensils, all the work, all the contributions that had been made out of love actually were why that sanctuary was filled with love, and in some way it catalyzed, of course, the Shekhinah, God's presence, to dwell amongst them, filling every possible place in the Mishkan. It's a deeply beautiful image that there was nothing without God's presence. It was Malei Kvodo, filled with God's glory. That is what is meant by the glory of God filling the sanctuary. In the tradition, of course, the finishing of the Mishkan is also likened to the finishing of creation. And if you heard, you hear it says Vayichal Moshe, that Moshe completed, and in a little while we'll say Vayichulu, and the creation was completed. So there are many things, if you follow the commentaries, that look at both the 7 days of creation, 6 days of creation, and Shabbat, and the building of the Mishkan that are likened to one another. And so there are a lot of commentaries that speak to this likeness. And so the likeness of the Mishkan being finished in this moment invites it, the afterness of that feeling, to be Shabbat. Right, that's the very essence of Shabbat, which is a completion of the work and the sense that we have to live now in the glory of God. It's very hard to live in the glory of God these days, particularly with the weeks that we're having, with the suffering that exists, with the hostages remaining in Gaza, with the death of innocent civilians in Gaza, with the election in this country coming down the pike and a lot of uncertainty about what will be. It's hard to kind of bring it on, to be filled with that kind of love. And yet, and by the way, right, the Mishkan also says the tradition is a tikkun for the worshiping of the golden calf. It's not like the Israelites hadn't been through hardship, but they built something different. They chose to give from a place of love in order to say there's actually something else to build in the universe. And so I want to invite us on this Shabbat, as the completion of the tabernacle comes to be, to think about the completion of our week. Where have we been this week? What have we encountered? And might we find a seal that says, okay, that's what it was, and now I'm going to bring some love into the space, some glory into the space. I'm going to not only bring something of myself with my voice and my connection to this place, to the world, but also I'm going to let it sink into me too. To say, while the world is filled with all these hard things, the world is also filled with very many beautiful things, of which if we touch one another and we feel that sense of connection and the offering that brings, that comes to be when we offer ourselves, when we help one another, when we show up for one another, when we sing together, that we actually feel more the glory of God than we will otherwise. And so it does take effort, just like it took the Israelites' effort to build that Mishkan. But the Mishkan was not about the things themselves. The Mishkan was about what they brought because of their love for God. What is your thing that you're bringing this Shabbat? And how might you fill a little bit this room and this world and your heart with a little bit of God's glory, a little bit of longing for that kind of love, so that we're choosing to bring something else than what we see in the world, and to triumph the beauty over the horror, to triumph love over hate, to triumph Shabbat over Chol, and to triumph a world filled with God's presence over emptiness. It's our choice to bring it, and I hope we all will this Shabbat. Nechadodi, page
Yeah. Hesuani ami, veni veta iratina. Ay, 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 Of Negeshurun mourns the death of our member Aaron Akabas, and we extend our sincere condolences to his children Miles and Sharon, Seth and Meg and Miriam, his grandchildren Sam, Sasha, Shai, Becky, Tal, Paulina, Lior, Shoshana, Josh, Eli, Ruven, Lev, Ariel and Jacob, and his great-grandchildren Belle, Nathan, Violet, Ezra, Aiden, Jasper, Dahlia and Elliot. And the community of BJ extends our sincere condolences also to Yvette Stern and Richard Stern and their son Benjamin Stern on the death of Yvette's mother Lucila Colon Rivera, and to Russell Makowski and Melanie Katzman and their son and daughter-in-law Winman and Amanda Makowski and the grandson Cameron Makowski and the granddaughter and son-in-law Harper Makowski and Trey Brederman on the death of Russell's father Jerome Makowski, and also we offer condolences to Julie and David and their son Owen on the death of Julie's father Ed Brown, and we say the words of consolation on page 26.
May the divine comfort you along all with all the other mourners of Zion and Yerushalayim. May you find comfort from heaven. You may be seated. We turn now to Ms. Moore Shirley Yom HaShabbat. We'll join together at Magad Lu.
May all
We turn now to RV to page 39A. Please rise in body or in spirit.
Baruchu et Adonai ha-mevorach. Baruch Adonai ha-mevorach le'olam va'eh.
Shinatam, ושופכה וחומכה, וקשרת מאוד על ידיך, והיו לטוטפות בין עיניך, וכתבתם על מזלו ביתך, ובישעריך,
ויהיה ושמע תשמעו לזה שאני מצוות אתכם היום לרבה.
Adonai Elohim Emet.
It's 43 a.m. Vemuna kozat v'kayam aleinu ki hu Adonai Eloheinu melech zilat ha'olam v'yisrael. Ha'el hanifra lanu mitzvah v'moshe v'nechon. Tzeret amo yisrael mitocham l'chibur toda. We pray for redemption. Page
44.
Oh,
Sham Rovene Israel. Shabbat le dor tam berit olam beni uven bnei Israel oti
Uvchaye lechol bet Israel ba'agala v'zman kariv imru amen yesh me'haba mevarach le'alam ule'alme almaya yitbarach
v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnasei v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shemed kudusha Leila min kol berchata v'shirata
Tush v'chata v'nechamata Damiran be'alma
V'imeru amen
V'shushalayim to the east on, with for the silent Amidah which begins the formal text on page 47 or please the own prayers of your own heart.
Thank you.
Vayachulu hashamayim veharetz vechotzevam Vayachal Elohim vayom hashvihi melachto asher asa Vayishbor vayom hashvihi mikol melachto asher asa Vayevarech Elohim et yom hashvihi Vayikadesh oto ki bo shabbat mikol melachto asher bara Elohim lason.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Elohei avoteinu veimoteinu Elohei Avraham Elohei Yitzhak Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sara Elohei Rivka Elohei Rachel Elohei Leah El Hagadol Hagibor Ve'anora El Elyon Kone Shamahim Ba'aretz
Vaginavot Bidfaro Mechayei meitim b'mamaro Ha'el ha'kadosh she'in kamohu
Amen yach me'amo b'yom shabbat kutsho Ki v'am rastal aniyach lahem
לפניו נעבוד בירבה פחר ונודה לשמו בכל יום תמיד
מאון הברכות אל ההודעות אדון השלום מקדש השבת ומברך שמי
ומניח בקדושה לעם מדושני עונג זכר למעשה בראשי
אלוהינו ואלוהי אבותינו אבותינו רעשה במנוחתנו קדשנו את צוותך ותן חלקנו בתורתך זהבנו מטובך ושמח נפשנו בישועתך ותאר ליבנו לעובדך באמת ונחילנו אדוני אלוהינו באהבה רצון שמר קודשך וינוח חובה ישראל מקדשי שמך ברוך אתה אדוני מקדש השבת קדיש שלם פיץ' 54
יתגדל ויתקדש מרבה ביעלמה דברת קירותי ומליק מלכותי בך יכון ובימכון ובכת כל בית ישראל בעגלה ובזמן קריב ואימרו אמן
יש מרבה מברך
לעולם ימי עלמיה יתברך
וישבח ופר וירומם וינעשה וידע דר וילה וילה שמיד קודשה
ריחו
מן קובר חטא ושיר עטא תשיש בחטא ונחם עטא דמירון במאבים מרו
אמן
תתאבל צורו בטון נכו יסרו קדם עבון משמיים וימרו
אמן יש למה רבה מן שמיה וחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואימרו אמן
עושה שלום במרומיו ויעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל ועל כל יושבי תבל ואימרו
We turn to Kiddush on page 55. Right, everyone, I think they're passing out juice and those at home to get a cup of wine or juice.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri agafen Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher kitshanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu V'shabbat kodsho v'ahava uv'ratzon Hinchilanu zikaron l'maseh v'reishit Ki hu yom techila l'mikrae kodesh Zeicher letziat Mitzrayim Kivanu Vaharta Ve'otanu Kidashta Mikol Amim Ve'shabbat Kodshecha Be'ahava Uv'ratzon Hinchalta Baruch atah Adonai Mekadesh HaShabbat
L'chaim.
L'chaim.
Invite all the children under the age of B'nai Mitzvah to come for a blessing. I see they're shaking their heads. They don't want to come up. there's Eloise. Eloise is here.
הגואל אותי המלאך הגואל אותי מכל רע יברך את הנערים בקרב האם שמי בשם אבותיי בשם אבותיי Abraham ve'yitzchak ve'yitgularo bekerev ha'aretz
Simecha Elohim Elohim kesara mivka rachav leya yisimcha Elohim kefraim uch menashe yivarechecha Adonai vishmarecha ya'er Adonai pan ave lecha vichunecha yisa Adonai pan ave lecha yasem lecha shalom.
Ken yiratzon, amen.
Shabbat shalom. Aleinu, page 56.
Aleinu l'shabeach nadon hakol latet gedulah yotzer bereshit lo osanu kekoye ha'atzot ve'lo osananu kemishpechot ha'adama she'lo osanu kekavem ve'gol aleinu kekol ha'munam v'anachnu koreim
כתוב בתורתך, אדוני ימלוך לעולם ועד,
ונאמר והיה אדוני למלך על כל הארץ.
ביום
ההוא יהיה אדוני אחד ושמו אחד.
We turn now to Mourner's Kaddish on page 58 and invite those who are in mourning or marking our yard site to remain standing and those who are on Zoom to unmute for Kaddish. Yitzkadal v'yitzkadash shemei rabba Be'ama divrak yirutei v'amlich malchutei V'chayechon v'yomechon v'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael Ba'gala uvizman kariv v'yemru amen Yehei shmei rabba mevorach le'olam olmei olmaya Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase V'yitadar v'yitale v'talal shmei l'kudusha b'richu Le'ela minkol v'rchata v'shirata Tushbechata v'nechamata da'amir Ran Bama Vimru Amen. Yehesh Lama Rabba Min Shemaya. Bahayim Aleno Velkoya Sarel Vimru Amen.
Amen.
May be seated. Shabbat Shalom to everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
We want to wish a Mazal Tov to Ron and Amy Gutman, the new grandpa, on the birth of their grandson, Cosimo Dov. I'm not sure I can pronounce the last name. Agnesin. And to his parents, Zoe and Sebastian. Mazal Tov. Very exciting. We want to extend our condolences once again to the Kabas family, the 27 of the clan, and to all the others who are in mourning, and particularly to Julianne, David, and Owen, who are here on the death of Julie's father, Ed Brown. We also want to say a Bruchim Abaim to Rabbi Oded Mazor from Kol Neshama in Yerushalayim, and wish you a big chizuk in these tough times, and to Rabbi Gisa Ederberg, who's also here from Berlin. I think their rabbinical assembly is having a law committee, and Oded was here for the CCRR, maybe, is that true? All right, we're really happy to have you, and they're with the Dean of JTS, Rabbi Ayelet Cohen. Anyone who's here for the Shabbat dinner with Ari is welcome to go through the hall here to the reception room. There may be a couple of seats open, so if you're looking for a space for Shabbat, please just wait at the end until we make sure that those who have signed up are seated, and then hopefully we'll have room for a little bit more. Tomorrow morning, there's going to be, along with the main service, will be at 9:30. Beginning at 9:15, there'll be a special mindfulness Shabbat morning service with Cantor David Mintz, Rabbi Shuli Passau, and Rabbi Mark Margolius from the Institute for Jewish Spirituality for a contemplative Shabbat morning service. They'll enter Shabbat morning through meditation, chanting, deep listening, and personal exploration before joining the remainder of the service for the Torah service. We'll then be followed by Kiddush on the third floor tomorrow evening. Havdalah, our Arvitin Havdalah is at 7:55. So welcome to the long Shabbatot. Wednesday evening, we have a book talk with Rebecca Claren called The Cost of Free Land. It's with connections, and Rebecca Claren is going to discuss her book, The Cost of Free Land, where she investigates the history of her Jewish ancestors' land in South Dakota and Lakota, who were forced off that land by the U.S. government. This should be a really important conversation. Saturday night, of course, is Purim. So you should be, I actually, you know, it's a struggle to imagine Purim this year. I just want to acknowledge that. And I think part of us needs to say, like, everyone needs Purim this year. Like, we actually need 24 hours or 25 hours of unbridled joy and to actually have a release, since it's been such a hard time. And I was spending yesterday afternoon with a delegation of Israeli rabbis at the Hartman Institute, and Rabbi Danny Siegel said that he just said that the notion of simcha is not necessarily the end, it's actually a vehicle to find something, which I think is an important distinction. We think that simcha means that that's where we are, but that simcha, according to also Nachman of Bratslav, who spoke a lot about simcha, but he wasn't the happiest man. He was actually a very challenged man in his mental health, and simcha is a pathway to something. So the question is, can we find a pathway to something else? So I invite you to think about that, and also that actually putting on a different costume helps us getting out of ourselves. And so we invite you to come on Saturday evening Here Comes the Spiel, our theater company, at 7, and 8 o'clock will be Shushan Night Live with hosted by Eli Battalion and Jamie Elman from Yidlai Crisis. They were here last year, and featuring BJ's teen band, Goldberg. Put on your favorite costume or perfect mask, hear the Megillah, and join us for Purim celebration. The other thing I just want to encourage, I think our sign up to do the exchange for Mishloach Manot has ended, but also giving, you know, just as I spoke about earlier, giving is what helps us feel love. And so Mishloach Manot on Purim is also really important to give, to express our love to our friends, and of course giving Matanot Yavionim, gifts to the poor as well. The Megillah reading will be next Sunday at 9:15 in the chapel and online, and then we'll have an early childhood Megillah reading, a Purim carnival from 11 to 2, and a Purim Su'udah that you can sign up for at 11:30. And then in the afternoon, we're going to fulfill the mitzvah of Matanot Levionim with the Purim Volunteer Project with the West Side Campaign Against Hunger, which is at the Church of St. Paul and St. Andrew. So we hope everyone will participate in some meaningful way in Purim. I think that is it. We'll join together for Shalom Aleichem on page 73.
etchem leshalom, malachei hashalom, malachei hashalom, malachei elyon, mi melech, malachei malachim, hakadosh, hakadosh baruch hu, etchem leshalom.
O God, source of life, help us feel a little glory this Shabbat, the glory of God on the inside, and the giving of that glory to the world around us for honor and for splendor, and allow us to say hallelujah to the love, to the beauty, to the life that there is to live, and to the peace yet to come. Adonai oz le'amo yitin, Adonai varech et amav bashalom, Shabbat shalom.
Amen, amen. Shabbat shalom.